Dr. Aisha Riaz, and today we'll be doing the practical on how to estimate hemoglobin by Sehi's method. So before estimating the hemoglobin, we should know what is hemoglobin. Hemoglobin is a conjugated protein that is present inside our RBCs. It carries oxygen and then carries carbon dioxide back to lungs. It is also a buffer that maintains the pH of blood. The principle by which we are going to estimate the hemoglobin is formation of a colored pigment, and this colored pigment is known as acid hematin. Its color is then compared with a standard tinted brown glass to measure the concentration in gram per 100 ml of the blood. This is the principle by which we are going to estimate hemoglobin. The apparatus we need is a Sehi's hemoglobinometer, a pricking needle and spirit swab. And the reagent we are going to use are N/10 HCl and distilled water. Procedure I'll demonstrate you. And this is the method for the this method is used for individual screening. Now we'll be doing the procedure. This is Sehi's hemoglobinometer. This is the comparator tubes by which we are going to compare the color of acid hematin that we will perform in this tube. ठीक है, this is the stirrer, glass stirrer. This is hemoglobin pipette and it has marking, as you can see, till 20 microliter. The reagent we are going to use is N/10 HCl. And also distilled water. These are the lancets by which we are going to prick the person, and these are the spirit swabs. I am going to show you this tube. It has two gradations. One is in hemoglobin gram percentage, that is graded from 2 to 24, and the other side that has a red marking on it, it is only the percentage from 10% to 140%. We are going to take N/10 HCl till 10% of the graded tube. This is the N/10 HCl. We will be putting it drop wise into the tube till the 10%. As you can see, ठीक है. Now we will be pricking. We'll do the pricking procedure. Clean the tip. Open the lancet. Clean the tip of the finger. Prick the finger, middle finger. And now take till 20 microliter in the hemoglobin pipette. Yes, now the blood is sucked till 20 microliter. Now we'll put it in the test tube. Like this. Mix it with the stirrer and mix it slowly so that the acid hematin is not break. Okay. Put it in the Sehi's tube and then we will wait for 10 minutes to let the acid hematin form. Now we will add distilled water to this acid hematin, that is a brown mixture formed. We will add it drop wise. Mix it with the stirrer. Slowly. And then we will compare it with the comparator. As you can see, the color is still not matched. We will now add more distilled water to it. Mix it with the stirrer again. Still the color is not matched, we will put more water. Still it is a bit darker, as you people can see, we will put more water. More water. Keep on adding water until the color matches with the comparator tubes. More water. More water. Still the color is not matched. Until the color is matched, we will keep on adding distilled water. More water. Now before matching it exactly, we are going to note the first reading. As you people can see, it is on point 13. Just a point before matching with the comparator, we have noticed the reading, it is still point 13. Now we will add more water. Now you people can see that it is exactly the same color as that of the comparator. Now we will see the reading, and it is almost 14. The reading is 14. We will add few more drops to lighten the color and note the third reading. And the final reading will be the average of all these three readings. And in this way we are going to, for example, now this person has first reading was 13, 14, and then next reading was 15. So we will add the three readings and divide it by 3, and we will have the hemoglobin percentage of that person. Thank you so much. Now I'll be telling the precautions. The important thing you should know is the precautions of this procedure. That is, your apparatus should be clean. Color matching should be done in clear light. Also, you should remove the first drop of blood so that there should be no mixing. And do not squeeze the finger. Color matching should be done in proper light, and blood sample and acid should be taken in accurate amount. And the important thing is the normal values that you should know, because as we are doing the hemoglobin estimation, we should know the normal value so that if there is any abnormalities, then we can figure out the reason for the abnormality. So the normal values for female are 12 to 14.5 gram per 100 ml of blood. In males it is 14.5 to 16 gram per 100 ml of blood. And in newborn it is 20 gram per 100 ml of the blood.